Hello and welcome. I am Morjax. This is Mordheim City of the Damned, taking a look at the new Undead DLC that will be coming out on Tuesday, the 25th of October. I'm going to be releasing a separate episode showing the warband and each of the units here, but I want this first episode to be looking at our campaign itself. So I'm going to be choosing Walk in the Fog. I'm choosing, as I always do, a better deployment here, and I've got two ghouls, one zombie, one dragon, a vampire. Eventually, I think I want to go towards five ghouls for their debuff, which is disease carrier. But I also want to take a look at the zombie scouts in the meantime. Okay, here we are at deployment. Let's take a look. We're in an arc, and our enemies are over here. We've got Gentleman's Free Company, so it is a human mercenaries warband. I'm just looking at where we got Wordstone. We've got one piece over here. I might put my my vampire over there and then have him rendezvous with everyone else who's going to be going south, I do believe. So let's see. We've got three henchmen, so I want to leave three slots. That's going to be one, two, three. So this fourth slot right here, is where I'll put my dreg. Niku von Drak. And these names are definitely in progress. My Patreon supporters are going to get a chance to name units that they would like to. And I should have put my zombie in the front, probably. Okay, here we go. I'm going to skip... Well, should I skip that wordstone? I probably should not skip that wordstone. And this is, you can see in the heads-up display, down in the bottom left, it says, like, total loading time. The bottom right says development build. I'm actually recording this a few days in advance of the full release. And so, things may change. The save file might get reset. I've been talking with one of the devs, and they said that I may be okay to continue to use the same, use the same build and the same save file. So we might get reset, but in the meantime, at least you guys can see, either way, you guys can see a little bit of how this warband functions. And I'm stricken with indecision. I think I'm going to head over here with the idea that he's going to head into the building there. And then we're going to rendezvous, maybe head through to the south. Let me just take a peek in here to see, because we've got backtrack turned on, so that makes things easier. All right, so he should be able to access here, and it looks like there's at least this one other way out, right through there, so that might be the way that we do things, and that's also going to dictate a little bit where I'm going to bring my other henchmen. Basically, I think I might scoop them down around the south of this building, and we're going to meet up right around in here, somewhere in this area here. That's the plan. I do like how the vampire looks. It's pretty good looking. Okay.
Objectives updated.
So yes, I am very excited to be sharing this with you. Now we've got, I think, with the Undead release, if I'm remembering correct, that is the original six warbands that released with the base tabletop game. So there were some other official warbands that released through the Town Crier pamphlet that they released down the line in the tabletop. Oh, look at the way he runs. He looks like Smeagol or a werewolf or something. And I forgot to customize this second guy, but that's fine. Powell. That will serve fine, I think. And I think, in the interest of keeping him hidden, well, you know what? No, because we'll be hidden, but we won't have eyes on the enemy either. So we're going to just stick him right here, put him in an ambush stance. I don't expect... He does this little thing with gesture with his arms. Meh, what's up? I'm a ghoul. And Jeremil. Oh, looking good. I like... See, this is what I put the little spikes on his back. And, like I said, I'll be releasing... I wanted the first episode I made to be gameplay footage. And so the second episode will be the warband setup, warband assembly, episode. But at least I wanted to jump straight into... Look at that upturned nose. I wanted to jump straight into the game itself. And here we have Grigor. You can do with no jaw or big hangy jaw. I like the big hangy jaw. And he's got the... looks like a sword snapped or a spearhead. Oh, he's got kind of a shambling gait too. He's speedy though. Man, I was expecting him to be kind of rough and tumble. His movement is low, which I think that we kind of expected. He is a zombie, after all. There we go. The camera's a little herk jerk. A little bit. Oh, you guys, I'm just really excited to share this with you. Looking good. And I can't wait to get a necromancer. Oh, that's sort of a weird half of a shield there. That's strange. I can't wait to get the necromancer because that's kind of my my thought right now is you can get the necromancer and the ghouls have this disease carrier debuff that they hit the enemy with. And then the necromancer has a spell that deals damage and it's amplified by how many of these disease carrier debuffs they have. They last for 3 turns and there's a few different things they can roll. In terms of what the debuff actually is. How come we have so much initiative? What is happening? All right, we're gonna head in here. And snag that. Scavenge.
Objective.
Scavenge. And he does have, what's this guy's name? Silvu Abiscu. Silvu out. Albiscu does have he does have a nasty head. He does have a bow in his offhand. However, archery is hard to do at the start. At the start of any warband, really. I think I'm a little bit torn because they have a potential, the dregs, to have quite good ranged capabilities. But, despite having that potential, their skill is they basically lend their power, some of their power, to the vampire. Let's do our little patented wiggle. And they have to be within 3 meters of the vampire to use, or the vampire thrall to use that ability. And so I think that they're going to be hot on the tails of the vampire. In order to buff them that way. So I'm a little bit disinclined to have them be ranged. So my plan right now for the warband, and this is certainly subject to change, is that I kind of want to have one or two Poisonwind Globadeers, one or two of the dregs, one or two, I guess that's too many heroes, of the, at least one necromancer for sure, and then we've got our vampire leader, and I think I want to do dregs on the henchman slots. So that's kind of my plan at the first. Let's see, I think we want to try to sweep back over to here if we can get it, so if we pop through the gate and go over to there, alternately, there's no way to get through the gates easy over here. We could potentially go through that building. I'm gonna go like this to try to get some eyeballs out into that alleyway through that gate directly north of where we, or the top of the screen right through that little gate over there if you can see. And Grigor, he's gonna be a little bit behind here. I should probably be hanging back to try to keep my guys together because as always with Mordheim, those of you who have seen my Mordheim videos know for sure, but for those of you that are new to Mordheim, you got to keep your guys together because you should never, ever pick a fair fight. You should have, you know, 2 versus 1, 3 versus 1, 4, or preferably 5 if you really get the clown car going. You can get 5 versus 1 in melee. Never pick a fair fight. You always want the odds in your favor significantly if you can help it. So I might not go too far ahead just to let my zombie and my the dreg allow them to catch up, because really my My ghouls and my vampire are pretty far ahead right now. I don't want them to get too far ahead. I do like the icon for the vampire. That's very nice. I like that. All right, our turn's almost up. They're collecting some Wordstone to bring to us. Our optional objective is Wordstone Rush. So we need 5 more pieces. We got one right here. 2, 3, 4. And they've gotten 3 pieces now. I'm almost sure it's these right here. 1, 2, 3 pieces. I would be very surprised if that were not the ones that they picked up. And that's a good thing because it means they're going to bring it to my very doorstep. They picked up 4 Wordstone now. I think that's going to be 1, 2, 3 here, and then I suspect 4 right there. They might be here already. That'd be a little scary if they're already right there.
Round has started.
And it would also make it harder for me to get my optional objective because I need to go further for other Wordstone. But we're going to go right here and go ahead and snag that.
Objectives updated.
Generally speaking, if you want to keep the Wordstone, it's good to grab it with your heroes. Because they're more likely, or they're less likely to get murdered. They're more likely to stay up versus your henchmen that tend to get knocked down. Then again, it's not a bad idea sometimes to throw your henchmen to the dogs in order to get some Wordstone. All right, this looks to be all still here. I see you. All right, we got an archer right there. We got their leader right there. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. This is gonna fill up our Wordstone, and then I'm just gonna backpedal. See ya! With the idea that I don't think that they can get to me yet this round, but if they can get to me, I'm just gonna stick him in an ambush right here, I think. I'd like for them to not be able to see me from the street. Look at the teeth and everything. Looking good. Looking good, Von Drock. Powell's turn. Okay, so now I have a decision to make. I could try to pile into this house, which is going to be a bottleneck, or I could try to entice them into this alleyway, which I think is going to be the better choice. I believe they tend to go towards your last known location. All right, he's got a halberd. I don't like that. I'm going to backpedal here again in the interest of trying to let my zombie catch up. And we're going to go, I think, right here. No, not the dodge. I wanted the ambush. Ugh. Case in point, don't click too fast. All right, that was stupid, so I'm going to put him right here. And you know what? No, I'll go right here. Put him in the ambush. I'm trying to get a good angle on that doorway. There we go. I like the look of that. Jar of meal. It's like malt o'meal, but out of a jar. A jar o'meal. The zombie is slow, but... he's basically caught up. If they come through and engage, they'll get here eventually. Yes, they took my bait and the ambush. Donk. I'm a little bit scared. Oh, the halberds hit so hard at the start, but we get a counter, and I think we'll be able to. Oh, good. I really don't like that. He's going to be backpedaling for the rest of the game. He's definitely going to be, I'm going to try to protect our drag. So we're going to take down their captain, and then I'm going to back off and protect the drag if I can. Oofta. That was, difficult. Hornrat's breath. Very nice. Overwatch. Okay. That's okay. We know that dude's right in there. Oh, man, the halberds hit so hard at the start. I kind of want to steal that from him after we murder his corpse.
A new round has started.
All right. There we go. It seems like the animations are a little speedier. The, like, injury, you know, when you hit them and then they flinch. I'm going to, here's the trick. I'm going to delay because I think in a moment we're going to destroy their captain. And as soon as we do, I want to back off with Silvio because he is very injured. All right, please let me clown car. Please, please, please. I think we can, no, we can't sneak in there. Okay, we can sneak in here. This is good. Terror test, fail. You are afraid of me. Because I got the mace. Now, I'm running maces because it makes it easier for us to hit. Maces give you a... There we go. And his inventory is all full. So, I'm going to park him right here. Well, where to? Maybe right... You know, I'll leave him right here. Because I can't loot. So, we're going to go into right here and into a dodge stance. I want to present my leader towards the front. All right, Jaramil, Maltomil. He's got backpack slots open, so he's going to move up here and loot Wordstone, and I really want that halberd.
Objectives updated.
Warp effect down. Let's see what that curse was. Minus climb, jump, and leap. I really don't care about that. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to move up just a little bit. Like, I'm doing my wiggle like that. So here's what I want to happen. They walk in through this thing and then I'll tackle them and they won't be able to get too far, hopefully. And that means I need to bring my other guys up. Like so. I might get overwatched right here. No, surprisingly not. Okay, I'm going to delay with him because we might be able to ambush with the first guy and then come in with the second guy. He is really hurting badly. He's at 9 life. Alright, there's zombies coming up in the rear. I'm going to park him right here. He is very, very injured. And he's got some Wordstone on him. So he could, I mean, one successful shot from a bow is going to take him down at this point. So he's kind of, sort of out of action for the round. Not really. Good thing is their morale, rather, in the top left corner is down to 24 out of 16. So when they get down below 16 morale, that little red bar there, they have to start testing for route. So I think that we'll have them on the ropes shortly. I mean, this is going pretty well. We need 2 more Wordstone to get our optional objective, which I really, really do want. I'll delay again there. And Grigor is going to come up as well. Now, here's an option. I might be able to go sit on this guy's face. Oh, do I want to do that? I kind of do. Oh, I can't. Okay. So he's going to go, what to do? All right, here's what we're doing. Going to backpedal a little bit and bring him over. Meow. Something like this. I guess that's okay. Not too bad. Let's see what this archer does here. I heard him right on the other side of that wall, so they are close. And I'm going to wiggle here. The idea with the wiggle is you can move a couple of feet without using a blue pill. I'm going to delay with the hope that the archer's going to come through the door. He'll get ambushed, and maybe I can move this guy into... Ah! Oh, dang, that dude's got a long rifle. Holy crap. I think we're too close to trigger that that long rifle attack. So I think we can come swooping through the door and jump on him. Yeah, see, we're really injured here. Let's delay. We might want to do something with him down the road. I don't know. And our best bet is definitely to get the leader in here. Hello. Ow. There's another dude right there. All right, we're going to activate clown car maneuver. Terror test, fail. Oh, it's a blunderbuss. Bonk. Yeah, we just need to take down one more guy, I think. Oh, the miss, dang it. And that's going to give us the... our dodge stance is a lot better. I should have pulled that shield off. That's going to give us what we need to make them rout, I believe. I probably should have piled up on that other guy because we can get more people on top of him. But whatever. It's water under the bridge now. Malto meal. Jaro meal. Did you have an ambush stance? Yep, you did. But you missed me. So no big deal. Disease carrier. Yeah, so let's look at... when we're going to bring our zombie up to fight this guy, and I want to look at the disease carrier debuff that he got. So I want to bring him up, but the thing about that is that he's extremely, extremely fragile right now. So we're going to just park him back here. And... you know what? I'm not even going to delay. I'm just going to stick him in a dodge stance and we'll call that good. I do need two more Wordstone. I'm hoping that these guys are carrying some on them, but I probably should not be holding my breath. Oh, here comes another dude. Werner. Grigor. Go get him, Zambi. Doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Womp-womp. All right. That other guy should not be able to access me, which is probably a good thing. Our parry stance is good. Our dodge stance is terrible. Because, you know, zombies. All alone fail. Free attacks. Yes, I love the all alone. Kerchop, Kerchop. Get wrecked. I forgot to check what disease carrier he had. So that other dude's probably going to come try to attack us. I'm not too worried about it. Oh, climb? Oh, he's going for my hero. No. Oh, good, good, good. Oh, I thought he was going to jump down. All on success. Terror test, success. You're a jerk. Switch weapons. Dodge fail. No problem. All right, we should be able to take down this archer at the top of the round.
A new round has started.
I'm worried about that guy. Oh, you know what I can do? I can go run for the Wordstone quick. Because we got two slots. Oh, I don't know if we're going to make it. All right, there's one piece. So we just need one more piece. I'm hoping that that archer has some on him. Otherwise, we might be in a little bit of trouble. And sure, we'll stick him in an ambush stance, because the best defense, a good offense or something. All right. Terror test fail. Oh, the crit. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. He's not down yet. We're cutting this really close with our optional objective. I'm going to delay here on the off chance that I can go run and grab. No, his stuff is full. All right, we're going to give hot pursuit to that dude who fled. Overwatch. That's unfortunate. Where'd you go? Ah, oh, crap, you went a long way away. All right. I really hope this guy has the wordstone I need. I hope this guy right here has the wordstone I need. Let's take a peek. Nope. We're going to take all the loose ends here. Actually, they're... okay, I'm going to put something back with the hope that maybe I can make it around to that wordstone over there if I wiggle just right. Ooh, this actually is looking pretty good. I think I'm going to make it. Because the optional objective is a huge deal. Yep, I got it. No. Gather wordstone.
Objective complete.
Oh, yes. I think we got it. And they'll probably fail now that their leader is toast. They'll probably fail their... let's see. That's their young blood. Werner. They'll probably fail their morale test, but they might not. Route test failure. There it is. And we got the optional objective and everything. An excellent way to start off our undead warband here. Very, very good. I love it. All right.
It is by deed that loyalty to Count Vlad is made manifest. Your triumph proves your devotion to Drakenhof. When the legions of Sylvania march on the Mor, your service to the master will not be forgotten.
Thanks, bro. All right, that went well. That went very, very well. Let's take a look at the spoils. Yeah, see, this is amazing. We got 3 for optional objective, 2 for surviving, 1 for decisive victory. So everybody's going to get 6 experience. He got another because he was MVP and... one more, let's close that. One more for being the, taking someone out of action. So everybody gets 6 XP for that first mission, which is really quite nice. Okay. And the spoils, we got heavy armor, great axe, amulet, wordstone, etc., etc. Halberd, blunderbuss shield. I'm excited about that halberd. So we need to pay our dues here. Now, I think we can... yeah, this warrior refuses to join a mission if you don't pay their upkeep. They will leave in 7 days. Well, how does that work? I don't get how that works. Whatever. I feel like you're supposed to be able to not pay the upkeep for the zombie or something. Let's take a quick peek at... oh my gosh, that halberd looks really sexy. Wow. I like it. Or the great axe. Okay. Heavy tiring. Slow is a better chance to be dodged. I'm going with the halberd right now. That's freaking badass. Let's take a look at the heavy armor. Oh my goodness, it looks so good. Ooh. We're going to be slow though. Our movement... well, no, our movement is on par with everyone else then. We've got 5 movement. The zombie's got 4 movement. See what the mace looks like. All right, that's just the same as the drag. It's like a little spiky thing. He could have the great axe? Really? Interesting. All right, you can give the great axe to the ghouls. That's good to know. I might leave it that way, actually. And you're going to get a mace. It's literally just a bone club. I like to run the maces at the start of the campaign because it makes it easier to hit the enemy. Let's see what the axe looks like. It's just like a wood cutting axe. All right. And I am half tempted to run doubles this way. Our dodge chance goes down by 10%, but our damage cranks way the heck up. I kind of like that for now. Yeah, dual wielding is potentially quite tasty. Okay, what's the difference here? The spear's a little faster. I think I might keep that spear. Oh, neat! Look at that spear. It's like a little curly trident. Let's see if I can... I don't know if you guys can see that spear okay down there. Looks very cool. All right, that is, ladies and gentlemen, that is our first episode of the Undead Warband. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm very excited for more of this, so I'm going to fiddle around my points off camera here, and we'll see you next time for more.